Any document that represents official correspondence from your company should be written on a document with a company letterhead. In this video, I'll show you how you can use headers and footers in Word 2013 to create a clean, professional letterhead template. Even if your company already has a letterhead template that you should use, you will learn a lot of things in this video that might be useful in other situations.
I want to create a letterhead that looks like this, with our logo added to the header and our contact details to the footer. As you can see, the logo looks a bit faded, a bit washed out. But this is just Word's way of showing you that this is part of the header. If we go to the print preview, you can see that the logo type will be printed in the full colors.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
To create a new template, I'll just start from a blank page by clicking New and then Blank Document. To insert your logo in the header, click the Insert tab and then Header. Here you have a number of built-in designs that you can choose from, but since we're only going to insert a logo type, select Edit Header. To insert the logo type, click Pictures, select your image, and then click Insert. A new button with layout options has been introduced in Word 2013 to help you position objects more easily. Click the Layout Options button and select Behind Text or In Front of Text. This way, you don't have to worry about text or margin settings. Resize the image by dragging the bottom right corner, holding down your left mouse key. Now you can position the logo exactly where you want it. To close the header, go to the Header and Footer Design tab and click Close Header, or just double-click outside the header area. Now, let's insert our company details in the footer. To insert a footer, click Insert and select Footer. To create a custom footer, click Edit Footer. To have more control over how the text is aligned, I'll insert the text into a table. To insert a table, click Insert and then Table. Here I'll select a 3x3 table. In the first cell, I'll type in our company name. I already have all of our company details in one of our brochures, so instead of typing them by hand, I'll just copy them from there. If you want to copy multiple objects, the clipboard is very useful. Go back to the Home tab. To open up the clipboard, click the little arrow in the clipboard section on the Home tab. Next, I'll open up the PDF document from where I want to copy text. I'll right-click the PDF document and select the Selection tool. I'll mark our email address, and then I'll press Ctrl-C on my keyboard to copy it. As you can see, a little pop-up tells me that the clip has been saved to the clipboard. I'll continue to copy our web address, postal address, telephone numbers, and finally, the Facebook page. The clipboard can hold up to 24 clips. When I have all of the information I need, I'll close down the brochure. I'll position my marker where I want to insert the postal address, and then I'll just click on the clip in the clipboard. I'll continue to add all the clips from the clipboard until I've populated the entire table. When I'm done, I'll clear the clipboard by clicking Clear All, and then I'll close down the clipboard. I'll mark the table and reduce the font size to 9 and change the color to a dark gray. I'll move the entire table down by going to the Header and Footer Design tab and reducing the footer from bottom distance to 0.1. I'll spread out the text by dragging the left side of the table further to the left, and then I'll do the same thing with the right side. I'll mark the text in the last column, go to the Home tab, and change the text alignment to right aligned. Finally, I'll just move the middle column a bit to even out the text. I don't want the lines of the table to be visible, so I'll mark the table, click Borders, and then select No Borders. Finally, I want to insert a line to have a clear divider. To do that, I'll click the Insert tab, and then Shapes. Here, I'll select a line. I'll hold down the Shift key when I draw the line to make sure that it's perfectly horizontal. I'll change the color of the line to a dark gray. Okay, let's see what this looks like. I'll double-click outside of the footer area to close it. I'll click File and Print to see the print preview. This looks good, so now I want to save it as a template. To save it as a template, I'll click Save As and change the file type to Word Template. I'll give the template a name, Letterhead Template, and then click Save. The template is saved in the template folder. Next time I want to create a document using this template, I'll click File, New, and then Personal. From here, I can access my newly created template. If I want to have it on the first page, I can just click the little push pin and my template will be easily accessible on the start page. From time to time, you might want to modify how headers and footers are displayed. Here I have a document where I've used my newly created letterhead template. I'll change the view so that you can see multiple pages. I don't want the cover page to have the header and footer. But if I open up the header and footer on the first page and try to delete the logo, it will be removed from all pages. To remove the header and footer from the first page but keep it on the remaining pages in your document, open up the header or footer and on the Design tab, in the Options section, mark the option to have a different first page. The contents of the footer and header are removed from the first page. As you can see, a unique header called First Page Header and a unique footer called First Page Footer is created where you can add pictures or text. For here, I'll just leave them empty. Let me open up another document. Here, I want to have our company header and footer on the first page, but I want the following pages of the document to have a different header and footer. To insert a header and footer that are different from those on the first page, place your marker on the page where you want the new header and footer to begin, and go to the Page Layout tab. Under Breaks, click Continuous Section Break. Now, click on the header on the second page. It says Header Section 2. In the Navigation area on the Design tab, click Link to Previous to unlink the header from the one in the previous section. Now you can delete the logo type, but only in the header in Section 2. The header in Section 1 is still intact. Here, I'll insert a different version of our logo. I'll click Pictures and select this logo flower image. Under the Layout options, I'll select In Front of Text, and then I'll resize the image and position it in the top left corner. To change the footer, mark the footer and click Link to Previous to unlink the footer. I'll mark the table with our company contact details, right-click and select Cut. Then I'll delete the line divider. I'll click Page Numbers and select one of the predefined formats. I'll close down the footer, and as you can see, you now have different headers and footers in the same document. By mastering headers and footers, you'll be able to create a wide range of professional-looking documents.